Wow. Hi guys, look what I found, a 40 years old General Electric oil-less pump. Let's have a look at its label. Here as you can see, it states 12 volts and 11.3 amperes, which are quite high, and the RPM of the motor is 3450. The date of manufacture, which is 3rd of March 1982, and they have also provided the toll-free number. So before opening it up, let's give it a spin. Here, I'm gonna use this 220 volts to 12 volts power supply that I constructed using a UPS transformer for charging my inverter battery. The output voltage is 15.6 volts. So the voltage has dropped to only 10 volts, which means that this machine is drawing huge amount of current from the power supply. Let's check the amperes. Stabilizing at around 6.5 amperes. So it was quite high for no load current. You see, I'm putting my hand on the outlet and it is getting loaded. 12 amps constant. But there is still one big problem, that the voltage is dropping from 12 volts to as low as 7.5 volts under full load. So for that, I'm going to change the transformer output winding tapping from minimum output to reach maximum power output. The new output voltage is as high as 32 volts DC. Yeah, there's going to be a huge spark. So here I'm going to use this high temperature plastic sheet. Let's put some pressure on it. So the maximum we did was around 18 volts, I guess. 16 volts. This motor is performing very good. I'm pushing it at the maximum performance or power output. So the amperes are rated around 11.5. Once again, you see 11.3. Now let's increase the load by putting a finger here. Max 21 amperes, very high. Wow, seriously, the output pressure of this pump is very high. This is the rotor, and here they have used some really cool technology. When this pump rotates, these sliders come out and the air in between the two sliders gets trapped, and then this air is taken to the exhaust chamber. This is the exhaust chamber, and this is the exhaust nozzle, and this is the inlet. So air is going to get inside from here and then come out from this slot, you see. Let's open up the rest of the motor. Now comes the close-up for the armature or rotor winding. As can be seen, the bearings are very high quality and it's printed on it NTN Japan, which says that it is made in Japan. As for the copper winding used in the armature, very thick copper wires have been used to carry huge amount of current. No wonder when I forced it at high power input, the current peaked at 21 amperes. The construction of the armature is similar to today's DC motors. There is no difference except for the quality. And the armature winding, it is so thick that it is somewhat like that of a bike starter motor. I won't say car starter motor because in that case the armature winding is even thicker, but compared to the bike starter motor it is identical. Seems like this pump wasn't used much. There is some rust present on the poles of the armature, but that is acceptable since it's been almost 40 years since this piece has been manufactured. Now let's get an inside view of the field winding of this motor. So as can be seen here, this pole is obviously an electromagnet type. It's not permanent magnet. These are the windings. I gave another look to its label and it was written DC compound motor. Let's place it back as it was before. Now there is one pointer. Always make a mark with a permanent marker on the disconnecting parts of a machine. And this way you will know for sure which side was connected to the rest of the body. Let's close it. So now that we have assembled it back, let's test it. Oh, it's working great.